Welcome to County Talk. I'm your host, Kirsten Peterson. Sarasota County is known for its white sandy beaches, temperate climate, and beautiful waterways. But what we're going to talk about today is Sarasota's deep-rooted history. We'll explore the early years, the arrival of the Scottish colony in 1886, and the internationally known architecture movement known as Sarasota School of Architecture. First up, we have Jeff LaHurd. Jeff is history specialist for Sarasota County's Historical Resources Department and the author of 15 books on history of Sarasota. Welcome, Jeff. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So first, you heard I obviously just mentioned about the Scottish.
Right.
Who were they and what were they doing in Sarasota County?
Well, they were a group of about 65 people who came over here in 1886 expecting to find a little Scotland. But when they arrived at Sarasota Bay, they found out it was just a wilderness. And there were a few settlers already here to help them. But after about 4 to 6 weeks, most of them had gone back to other parts of the country.
What part of Sarasota did they initially arrive to?
Well, they arrived near where Marina Jack is today on Sarasota Bay. And they were really disheartened because they had traveled so far. They had sold all their possessions, said goodbye to family and friends, and then to step ashore in what was basically a wilderness was very disheartening. And I wrote down a quote that one of them said before he
left.
Share
it with us.
This is from someone named Dan McKinley. He surveyed the situation and said, "Picture us alone in the woods, in our little log hut. It's a queer experience and I can't describe it. I'm going to light my pipe, for I feel very sad."
That's sad. How did they arrive here initially? Was it obviously by ship? But where was the port that they came into?
They came to New York, then they took a train most of the way down. And when the colony failed, they sent John Hamilton Gillespie over to revive the effort. And he put into place some of the infrastructure that should have been here before the colony arrived.
What are some of the names that are left behind that would point to the Scottish settlers?
Well, there's a marker down at the bayfront, for one thing. And then Gillespie Park is named after John Hamilton Gillespie. Gillespie Avenue, Browning Street, named after the Brownings, who were among the original colonists. So there are still things scattered around Sarasota.
So let's move up a few years.
All right.
A lot of Sarasotans have heard of a famous name as Bertha Palmer. Tell us about Bertha Palmer.
Well, Bertha Palmer came in February of 1910. And she had several contributions to Sarasota. She bought thousands of acres here. But I think one of the biggest contributions is she put the international spotlight on Sarasota. Because before that time, before 1910, not too many people, even in Florida, knew where Sarasota was. Well, she was a world-renowned socialite, and everything she did was played up in the papers internationally. So when she declared that Sarasota Bay was more beautiful than the Bay of Naples, it generated a lot of interest in Sarasota. And she set up what I would call a Chicago connection. And a lot of wealthy people from Chicago came down and made their winter homes here.
Followed her here.
Absolutely.
To see what she was talking about.
Yep.
So, okay, 1886, Bertha Palmer years were what years?
She came here in 1910. She died in 1918. And then probably the next big event would be the 1920s.
Tell us about the 20s.
Well, the 20s, they were roaring throughout the nation, but they were really roaring in Sarasota.
Even down here in Sarasota.
Yeah, the mayor, A.B. Edwards, who was the first mayor of the city of Sarasota, said that enough growth happened in 5 or 6 years that would have taken another town 50 to 100 years to complete. I mean, every place you looked between about 1922 and 1926, building was going on. Churches, schools, hospital, housing developments, banks, everything to be a bona fide city took place in about 5 years.
Tell me about A.B. Edwards specifically.
A.B. Edwards is one of the great men in Sarasota's history. He was known by the time he passed away as Mr. Sarasota. He was born in Sarasota, he lived in Sarasota, saw all the changes in Sarasota. In fact, he was one of the people that interested Bertha Palmer in coming down and buying property here. But he built the Edwards Theater, which we know today as the Sarasota Opera House.
Oh, I'll be darned.
Yeah,
Which is still active today.
Absolutely.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. So when we look at that building, that's really the A.B. Edwards building. Is that correct?
It is A.B. Edwards building, right. It was opened as the Edwards Theater in 1926.
Wow. Wow. Let's talk about moving up to the war years and depression years a little bit. What was going on in Sarasota County during those years?
Well, the real estate bust occurred September of 1926, and it was just as somebody threw a switch. Everything stopped. If there was $4.5 million in building permits in 1925, by 1932, that number was under $50,000.
Wow.
So significant. And the only way Sarasota really got through those years was some WPA projects, some Works Progress Administration projects. The Lido Casino, the Post Office, the Municipal Auditorium.
We even had a casino here?
It wasn't a gambling casino. It was just for dancing and dining and having a good time.
I see.
So that helped us, that helped carry us through. And nothing really changed. If you came to Sarasota in 1925 and came back in 1955, you basically came to the same place.
Wow. So not much happened.
Not much.
What about Venice?
Well, Venice was practically a ghost town when the real estate crash occurred. It truly was. I think as late as 1950, there were only 500 people living in Venice. But what Venice had going for it during those years, they had the Venice Army Air Base that had 3,900 people, and they also had Kentucky Military Institute that would come down in the wintertime and train here. So that helped. And Sarasota also had an Army Air Base here with about 3,500 men. So during the war years, we had thousands of soldiers training here, and a lot of them vowed to come back after the war, and they did. They came back and retired here.
And bought property and helped Sarasota become what it is today.
Absolutely, yes.
I know I've been to Venice Airport a few times, and you can see they have some markers down there, and you know, you can see where, and it's hard to believe that it was such an active area during that time.
Yeah, particularly because it was such a contrast to how it was after the real estate crash.
Interesting. I'm sorry, Jeff.
No, I was just going to say, I think the next biggest thing to hit Sarasota was in 1950 when the city manager, Ken Thompson, was elected and channeled Sarasota's growth for the next 38 years.
Interesting. Jeff, I want to thank you for joining us today. You're a wealth of knowledge, and I hope the viewers out there have also enjoyed hearing.
Well, thanks for having me. I really appreciate it.
Jeff LaHurd, thank you. So we're going to take a short break, and when we return, we'll discuss the internationally known architectural movement, Sarasota School of Architecture. Stay with us.